الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My dear respected brothers and sisters, mothers and elders in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. As we find ourselves on another blessed day of Friday, another Jum'ah, another day to reflect upon ourselves and to introspect and to look within our deeds and look within our hearts and look within our souls and look within our families to see what improvements we've made from the previous week, to see where we remain deficient and what we can improve on before the coming week. We find ourselves in a time of much change from even just the last Friday until now. Allahu Akbar Kabira, so much has changed in our society, so much has changed in our community. A lot of questions are being asked, a lot of thoughts are being expressed. And as we mentioned in the previous week, we want to maintain and hope that everyone is taking an opportunity to really listen to one another, to try and understand other perspectives, to not be so set on one specific opinion, but rather to be able to strengthen even your own opinions by listening to the opinions of others. And as so much has been said about racial diversity and racial segregation even, and racial inequalities and inequities in our society, I was forwarded a bit of information from our dear brother Imam Kifah in Orland Park. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. Allahumma ameen. And it was really such a simple message, yet a beautiful wake-up call. So much has been said on our Islamic platforms, different masajid and different imams and organizations posting about how Islam, came to conquer racism, and Islam came to wipe out this concept of one person being better than another. It was such a simple message that I want to share with each and every one of you today with regards to our five pillars. Something so fundamental to our faith that literally, why are they called five pillars? Why did the Prophet ﷺ describe them as five pillars of Islam? Because literally our entire faith is built upon these five concepts. That without this basis, without this, without this base, everything else is going to crumble. So without any one of these things, your platform is weak and shaky, and anything that you try to build on top of it will also crumble easily as well. So with these five pillars, and in looking at these now today, the way it was shown to me a few days ago, looking at these five pillars with regards to what Islam says about humanity is so manifest. And I want to share this with you today. As many of you already know, alhamdulillah, what are our five pillars? The shahada, the prayer, fasting, zakah, and hajj. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, inshallah, this isn't new information for any of our Muslim brothers and sisters. And for those who aren't Muslim, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the straight path, and may this be a reminder for each and every one of us. We begin our faith with the shahada, right? The testimony of faith, the awareness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one supreme. No one else is worthy of any worship. No one else is worthy of any following. No one else is worthy of any bit of madh or hamd, praise or excellence, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With our shahada, we immediately negate any and all forms of worship other than the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We say, La ilaha illallah. We conform to only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's superiority, only the excellence and magnificence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else is even worthy of comparison when we talk about the majesty and the amazingness and the wonderfulness and the awareness and the power and the knowledge and the wisdom and the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second part of our shahada, وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. And we testify to the prophethood of Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, a man who was par excellent, who was the excellent example that we have created within the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah says, "Husnul khuluq," the best of creation, the best of character, and how the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, you know, the examples of racial diversity and racial, you know, acceptance, and even going out and seeking opinions from people that were of other means of thought than himself, is the seerah is absolutely full of such examples. From among his companions, from among those who came and joined later, from those he met in Medina, from those who came with him from Mecca, the Muhajirin, the Ansar, so many beautiful examples, and inshallah perhaps we'll be able to expand upon this at a later time. But we testify to the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam as being the Nabi of Allah, the final messenger, the one whose word stands with us as an example, as a law, until the end of time. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the slave and messenger and servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his final messenger, and we follow that message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Whatever the Prophet gave us, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوا, take it, وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ, whatever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told you to stay away from, فَانْتَهُوا. And we see this so beautifully exemplified in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the examples given to us in the Quran and in the Hadith, so that you and I may purify ourselves of any and all means of worship of this world, any and all means of thinking that one is better than the other, which then brings us to the other four pillars, which are actions, which are ways in which we put our shahada into daily practice, and that begins with the salah. Five times a day, a Muslim will raise their hands and bow their heads and lower themselves in humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Recognition that I am from dirt and I am no greater than anyone else in Adam min turab. Adam alayhi salam, our father, was from dirt, was created from a clump of clay. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala formed and only blew the ruh into him when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saw fit. And we are all from Adam alayhi salam, no better than anyone else. Even our father Adam, it's taught to us in Sira. If you followed along perhaps in one of our lessons of the Lives of the Prophets alayhi salam series, then you would know that, you would already know this, and I'm going to share it as well, that Adam, peace and blessings be upon him, it's mentioned in Hadith that the dirt that Adam was created from was collected from all the different parts of the earth. So Adam was one, and we all came from Adam. So none of us is any better than one another. And really being able to put that into action in our salah, that we humble ourselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We recognize that I am not capable of doing anything, but that it is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not I that will guide anyone, but it is Allah who will guide me. And so we say, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. I am not great, nor anyone else is worthy of greatness. But when I'm bowing, I am praying and calling out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Subhana Rabbi, all praises are to my Lord, al-Azim, the magnificent and the great. When I lower my forehead on the ground, a physically humbling position, I also call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, I am so low, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is on high. Our salah teaches us humility. Our zakah, when we purify our wealth and we purify ourselves and we take care of one another, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us to be there for each other, financially and physically and socially and emotionally and spiritually, that we need to look out for one another as a community. We need to be there for one another. We have to actually take from our wealth, our hard-earned wealth that we have been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It wasn't ours to begin with, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala entrusted it to you so that you may take care of others. And if you are not one who gives zakah, then you could be one that receives zakah. And so one in one, those hands come together, and that is how the sound of change is made. Then we move forward to our fasting. Alhamdulillah, we've just completed a few weeks ago the blessed month of Ramadan, a time in which we were training our nafs, training our inner self and our inner desire to overcome our learned behaviors, that perhaps we were engaged in sin, perhaps we were engaged in habits, perhaps we were engaged in regular activities that were displeasurable. In the month of Ramadan, we put a stop to each and every one of those because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called us to leave that which is normally permissible only for the pleasure of Allah. So if you can overcome that, those needs that we have on a daily basis, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then you can also overcome those things which you do not need, those things which will not add benefit to your life, those things that will not increase the value of your existence on this earth. You can overcome those base desires. You can overcome those learned behaviors. You can overcome those bad habits by fasting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an entire month of training, which I hope that we are still continuing on. We find ourselves in the month of Shawwal, the fasting of the blessed 6 days of Shawwal. Alhamdulillah, here now we're almost in the middle of the month, that we're hopefully taking advantage of that, earning the reward of fasting, continuing that physical and spiritual and emotional training for one another in the blessed in the blessed act of fasting. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept that. Our five pillars culminate with the pillar of Hajj, that at least one time in an individual's life, that a person must testify to the greatness of human diversity. That when a person will go for Hajj, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept if we have gone, and may Allah take us if we have not gone yet. Say Ameen. That for the Hajj, an individual will recognize the value of human diversity, and rather the unity that exists in that diversity. Anyone who's gone for Hajj, alhamdulillah, I went a few years ago, and one of the biggest lessons that I learned was patience and acceptance of one another. You hear languages that you've never heard. You see skin tones that you've never seen before. You interact with people that you have never and perhaps will never ever see again. And all of this is part of the beauty of our faith, that what is the one thing that brings all these different groups of people together? It is none other than the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we make full circle back to our shahada of la ilaha illallah and the example of Muhammad Rasulullah. My brothers and sisters, our deen, our faith is very simple, and our faith calls us to worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, of removing these imagined barriers that we have created for ourselves, thinking that it is our race or our skin color or our national origin or our ethnicity or our language of choice or our mode of dress or our amount of money made or our levels of education, thinking that those are what make anybody better or worse than one another. Impossible. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who declared in the Furqan, the one determining factor, that which disseminates between right and wrong, that which disseminates between truth and falsehood, in the Quran itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that none of you is better than anyone else. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The only characteristic that sets an individual better than anyone else is taqwa, conscientiousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And conscientiousness has no color, conscientiousness has no language, conscientiousness has no country of origin, conscientiousness does not dress a specific way, conscientiousness does not earn a specific salary, but rather conscientiousness is known only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, my advice to each and every one of us today on this blessed day of Jum'ah, or whenever you're going to be listening to this, is that we put aside and we put away these barriers that we have constructed between one another, and rather we build bridges to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray, Allahumma ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, Allahumma ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, guide us to the straight path, the path of those whom you have shown your favor upon, neither those who strayed too far and earned your anger, nor those who strayed too far and were lost, but rather give us that straight path. Allahumma ameen. Wa akhru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.